a bunch of hogwash. So I'm gonna give our dear friend Wendy a call so we can put an end to these silly rumors. And, oh, it looks like we already have her on the phone line. Wendy, hello.
Hi there, Pat.
That's not Wendy.
No, this is Jim Fittimore. Remember, we were gonna do the announcement today.
Oh, was that today?
Listeners, we have Jim Fittimore with us and the director of the Bright Falls Community Theater, and I'm here to announce that the theater will be losing one of its most dignified thespians, as I, Jim Fittimore, will be running for mayor! Hold for applause.
Well, that's quite an announcement, Jim. Just let me find my notes here. I have some questions written down for you. The real question is what happened to this town. Bright Falls used to draw in thousands of tourists with its vibrant art scene and impressive bird feeders. And what's our reputation now? Haunted Bright Falls. Spooky Bright Falls. The world is laughing at us. And now all this business with the FBI? We need a mayor who can turn this town's reputation around. And nobody knows more about the role of mayor than I do. I played one in the theatrical production of Fiorello. The glowing reviews by Coffee World magazine. Mayor Setter is a joke. And you know what? I hear he kills kids. There. I said it. Now, Jim, this is a family show. I found my notes here, so why don't we pivot to some questions? First question, what exactly goes into that delicious beef jerky? Right, looks like these are my questions for Wendy Davis and Davis Family Beef Jerky.
The only jerk I care about is Mayor Setter. Our future's at stake. Pets are being murdered. And it's time for a change. Jim Fittimore for mayor! That concludes our program today.
Well, I actually have more.
Jim Fittimore and Pat Maine signing off.
More of those rhymes. Doesn't make sense. Ugh. That's not right. Nope. Yeah. Another lunchbox. I can use this charm on my bracelet. Keep trying. There's another lunchbox.
Saga strained to pull the string of the crossbow back as far as she could. To her surprise, the latch adjusted to accommodate her. The next bolt would stop a monster. Scratch stalked through the forest, a terrifying dark presence in the night, more sensed than seen. Darkness boiled in his skull, like a storm cloud crammed into a bottle. The woods were alive with those he had taken. They were coming with him, directed by him, his army of darkness. His singular purpose was a sharp, pulsing black hole in his head, waves roaring out of it to whip his flock into a frenzy, filling them with his purpose. The clicker. He wanted it. To make his horrific ending to the story come true. The art was there. The clicker would push it across the final threshold, a detonator to send out a tidal wave that would spread to overtake reality. He was so close to claiming it. The Taken gibbered and shouted, straining against their invisible leashes, filled with bloodlust. Scratch let them go. They launched themselves into the night with violent glee. He ripped a signpost from the ground, swung it in his hands as if it was made of air. Ahead, the music started. It called him on. Let the final deer fence commence.
Hello? Anyone here?
Nope. Did they get out? Did the Taken get them? Or were they turned into Taken? I'll need to get the key to the trailer park myself. Ilmo said the key is kept in the gift shop safe. Another one of those cult boxes.
Thank you.
something to Jimmy had opened with. A list of maintenance work. A screwdriver. Huh. Coffee World. The most caffeinated place on Earth. And yet nobody's here to help me get that key. Okay. Using screwdrivers to break into gift shops isn't exactly standard procedure. When you ask, Marisetta will speak. another cult stash? Can't be opened on this side. A fuse is missing. Can't operate the ride without it. Nah.
Jesus! Calm down, Saga. It's just a pot of coffee.
Have a beautiful day.
Thank God.
Jesus!
Should get that gift shop open. Another one of those lunch boxes.